Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Feel free to subscribe to my channel, ring the bell. One quick note before I dive into this video. The Microsoft Teams online training course just got 8 new modules added to it. It is right at 3 hours. There'll be a link down below if you're interested in the best online Teams training around. Today's video, I'm going to use Excel. I'm going to use Google Maps, and I'm going to use another app to calculate how much time do you need if you're flying to get to your gate on time from your home or hotel room. Let's go ahead and dive in right now. So here you go. I have already checked in. I fly out tomorrow morning, which is a Monday. Today's a Sunday. I really don't care what airline you're flying. I'm with Delta. So what I want to show you is on my mobile phone. Let me pull this up. You're looking actually at my mobile phone on the screen. Since I've already checked in, Delta is telling me that we depart at 7:15 in the morning, but Delta recently changed the amount of time needed for boarding. I believe it used to be 30 minutes. If you notice now, 6:35, so that is 40 minutes. So I want to be at the gate, which is gate B, B as in blue, 27, at Hartsfield-Jackson Airport, the busiest airport in the world. I need to be there by 6:35 because I like to be there when boarding starts. So I like to talk about what it is I need to do. Well, I'm either going to Uber from my house or I'm going to drive. But if you drive, you need to give yourself time to park. You got to go through TSA security, and you could have a TSA pre-check or global check or something like that. Or maybe you don't, but you need time for that. You got to get on the Hartsfield-Jackson. They call the train the plane train. Got to take that to my gate. Do I want breakfast and coffee before my flight? Sure. So we're going to use a map of the airport also to figure out where I'm going to eat. So let's dive in right now. Here's the key time. That's 6:35. So I'm going to crank up Excel. I have already set up this spreadsheet. There is my 6:35 boarding time in cell F1. The question is right here, when do I need to leave my house? What's the latest I need to leave my house? Over in column A, home to the airport, 45 minutes. How did I figure that out? Let's talk about that. So I've pulled up Google Maps. Google Maps, my home, to the airport. You can change this from leave now. This is what you definitely need to do, to either depart at or arrive by. I just threw in a time of 6 a.m. I know that's not enough time, but what I'm looking for is the maximum time it would take to get there. And I'm looking at roughly 45 minutes is the max that I see over here. So I put in 45 minutes. If I needed to park, this would definitely change something. Maybe it takes 20, 25 minutes to park and then walk over there. So there's zero for me. TSA pre-check or TSA. I have TSA pre-check. It takes me about 20 minutes. How do I know that? From previous flights. The plane train to get to gate B, which I just showed you back on my mobile phone a second ago. Roughly 10 minutes for that. Do I want breakfast? Yes. I'm going to tell you why I picked Chick-fil-A in just a second. Do I want coffee? Yes. I picked Dunkin'. And again, I'm going to show you why I decided to go to these two. Restroom break? Sure. Add up all that time. 105 minutes. So let's talk about how I'm going to convert total minutes to time. I don't want to sit here and do it in my head, even though it's pretty easy. And then I'm going to do a must do, but let me tell you why I decided for breakfast and coffee. Not every airport does this, but the large ones definitely do. I have pulled up Hartsfield-Jackson Atlanta International Airport. You can come and click over here. Here is where Delta is located on the south. Here is the north. When the Uber dropped me off at Delta, I know this from experience, but if I've never flown before, this is a great tip. You're going to get dropped off. Notice the Delta check-in, check-in, check-in. And then here's your TSA pre-check. If you don't have TSA pre-check, you're going to come through this one over here, which will take a little longer. After pre-check, I get on the plane train or the train that takes you to Concourse A. I'm going to zoom out here. Concourse A or Concourse B. Back to my mobile app. I'm headed to gate B27. I need to be there by 6:35. Click on Concourse B. I'm in Concourse B, pull up here, and there's gate B27 right there. And sitting next to B27 is a Dunkin' Donuts. I love Dunkin' Donuts coffee. I click it here, their hours, Monday through Sunday, 6:30 to 4. I'm cutting it really close, getting a coffee at 6:30 if I board at 6:35. So we'll see on that one. That may not happen. If that doesn't happen, I would get a coffee somewhere else, but I do love Dunkin'. Back here, and by the way, 6:35 starts boarding. I'm not in first class. I don't have any reason to board early, so it may be 6:45 or 6:50 before I get on there, but it's right by the gate. Now, I wanted breakfast. Let me zoom back out. And I specifically wanted Chick-fil-A, and I happened to do a search here. Because a lot of places are not open that early, but there's Chick-fil-A at Concourse A, which I pass before I get to Concourse B. Click over here, and it's telling me it's on Concourse A west of center. Here's what that means. I get out of that. Here's Concourse A west of center. Go west. Chick-fil-A right there. So they open at 6. It's amazing to me. As busy as Hartsfield-Jackson Atlanta International Airport is, the few number of places that are open at 6 for breakfast, even though there's a lot of places there. That's probably where I'm going to stop and get breakfast. Pop back on the train, go to Concourse B, or even walk it. So back to Excel so you understand how I like to plan my day. So we already discussed the 45 minutes, parking, TSA, on and on, Chick-fil-A, coffee, restroom, 105 minutes. How do you convert minutes to time? Because it's not always going to be 105 minutes. You take that number and you divide it by 1440. I'll go ahead and tell you this. It's not going to show up that way. It's going to look like this. All you need to do is right-click on that number, go to Format Cells, or Control-1. And you want to tell it to be time, 105 minutes is 1 hour and 45 minutes. Now, I've added a must do here. What is a must do? Let me add a column. Here you go. Before I do the must do equals F1 when boarding starts minus 1 hour and 45 minutes. I need to leave my house if I want to do everything that I have on this list here at 4:50 a.m. just to be safe. Let's throw in some must-dos and do another function. Yeah, X means you must do it. I'm still putting an X for parking even though it's zero, so if you filled it in, it is a must-do. You got to get through TSA. You got to take the train or walk. Breakfast is not a must-do. Coffee is not a must-do. Restroom is a must-do. So here we go. I want to know how many minutes it takes for the must-do. This is just going to be a sum if range, what criteria in the final argument is what range do you want to sum? Here are my must-dos, comma, they have an X, comma. What is it I want to sum up if they have an X? Make sure that these ranges match D2 to D8. B2 to B8, or else you'll get the wrong number. Control enter, 80 minutes. Again, time for must do. That number divided by 1440. By the way, in case you're wondering, Chris, why is it 1440? 24 hours in a day, 60 minutes in an hour is 1440. Instead of me going to format sales, I'm just going to use the format painter. I clicked on the 1 hour and 45 minutes. One more time, format painter. There you go. We'll call this leave to. So I technically could leave at 5:15 a.m., but I'm going to take the 4:50. I'd rather just get there and make sure I get on this flight, or I could be in trouble. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. I will make this Excel file available for you. If you want it, I'm going to blog about this. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. And don't forget about the Teams online training if you are a Microsoft Teams user. Best training class you'll ever see. Have a great day. Thank you.